Welcome back, welcome back, my bosses. You are my bosses. I'm teaching you, but I want you to be bigger than me. That's what I want. So I'm investing on you so that later I can get something from you, from your head, from the skills that you'll be having. And I'll be glad if one day I'll meet one of you, because I have met some of my students, but there are more new students that I never seen. So I wish one day we could meet and exchange and see how you can speak English, how you can speak French, and how you can speak Swahili. Let's go with this. We are moving first with the verb to have. Remember, it's a special offer. All this I'm doing for free, because I love you, because I like you, because I need you to have something good. This is the foundations that I'm doing, so that when we start the real courses, you'll be able to understand and to move on. We begin with the verb to have on the affirmative form. The verb to have on the affirmative form. In French or en français, on dit ceci, le verbe avoir au forme affirmative. Le verbe, this one, verbe avoir. Verbe avoir au forme affirmative. Kwa Kiswahili tunasema kuwa na. Avoir, ça veut dire kuwa na. We begin with English. I'll be connecting all of them so that you can all understand, in short. That's what I want. I want somebody who knows English can also learn French, in the meantime learn Swahili, and vice versa. Somebody who knows French can learn English and Swahili, and somebody who knows also Kiswahili only can get French and Swahili. That's why I'll be combining the all three languages in the same style so that you can get them. And on the review, I'll be specifying the languages, make some specification, and that will be after 30, when I'll have a clear list of the students who will pay for the fee. So I'll begin with a special program for them, but this one I'm doing it for free for everybody, okay? We begin by I have. I have in Francais, it is j'ai. J'ai like this. You put G and I and A and I. I have j'ai. In Kiswahili, it comes mimi nina. I didn't translate this. Muundo wa kukubali. I'll be giving you notes. I'm sorry. This whiteboard, sometimes I can write with a bad style, but I'll be giving you notes properly. This one, affirmative form, sorry for going back. Affirmative form, in Francais, it is forme affirmative. Kiswahili, muundo wa kukubali. Affirmative, kukubali. Affirmative, accepting the positive things. This one, kukubali. We begin again. I have. J'ai. Mimi nina. Mimi nina. You are accepting that you have something. That's mimi nina, muundo wa kukubali. You have, tia, wewe una. He has, ila, yule ana. It has, nous avons, sisi tuna. You have vous avez, nyinyi muna. It means you people, you guys, you have it. You have something. Vous avez, nyinyi muna. And at the end, they have. Ils sont wale wana. Wale wana. Wale wana. Are you getting this? I want you to follow perfectly so that when you are using the words, you'll be knowing what you are using. Not only keeping, memorizing, no, but you have to know so that when you are writing, it will be easy for you to know what am I writing. I begin first. I have, je, mimi nina. You have, dia, wewe una. He has, ila, yule ana. As I told you last time, for those who were at the beginning, on English, the gender matter only on single. The gender matter only on single, but on plural, the gender doesn't matter. It comes with one thing, which is they. He, she, and it will come, all of them, they. But in French, the gender, it matter. And on Swahili, it's like on English, the gender also doesn't matter. But on French, it's special. It's an exception thing. The gender is matter on singular and on plural. So, ila, it's a gent who has. Ila. He has, ila, it's a gent. Ela, it's a lady who has. She has. When we come on plural, on English we say they have. It's all of them, they have. But on French, because it's special, they respect gender system, they say ils ont. They will put S on il. Ils ont. Elles ont. They will show that these are gentlemen and these are ladies. On Swahili, I come fast to not take a lot of minutes, because this video mustn't be long video, it must be short, so that you can easily have that understanding that I want. Mimi nina. It changed as mimi nina, wewe una. What changed exactly? It's this side, like it's changing here, it also changing. Nina, una, ana, tuna, muna, wana. These are changing. And now what I was talking about, the gender on Swahili style, it's not respectable that much. Yule ana. Yule, it's he and el, it's he and she. It's in global. Yule represents a man, represents a woman, represents a lady, represents a gent, represents a young boy, represents a young girl. That's Yule. And sisi, nu, we, plural, kwa wingi, sisi, nyinyi. Wale comes like here on English, they. Wale represents gentlemen, ladies, everybody. So thank you so much for getting this special offer of the auxiliary verb to be at the affirmative form. Je disais ceci, merci beaucoup d'avoir cette offre, d'avoir cette offre du verbe avoir aux formes affirmatives. Cette forme que j'étais en train d'enseigner ici, c'est une forme affirmative. La forme qui montre que vous avez quelque chose, la forme d'accepter, la forme positive en fait, forme affirmative. Nilikuwa nasema hivi wapendwa. Huu ni muundo wa kukubali. Yaani muundo unaonesha kuwa unakubali jambo, kuwa una jambo, kwa sababu tense hii ni tense kuwa na. It means una kitu fulani. Sasa ili uweze kutengeneza sentensi nzuri kwa kutumia tense ya kuwa na, inatakiwa ujue mtiririko wa mfumo mzima wa tense hiyo. Kwa mtu mmoja, kwa mwanamke, kwa mwanaume, kwa watu wengi, ndiyo maana nimefundisha hapa kwa kifupi. Mimi nina,
wewe una, yule ana, sisi tuna, nyinyi muna, sio mna, muna. You have to pronounce muna. Nyinyi mnacho. Nyinyi mnacho hicho kitu. Nyinyi mna magari. Nyinyi mna manyumba. You have to pronounce. Wale wana mapesa. Wale wana mashamba. So I'll be tomorrow, I'll come now with sentences so that we can see how it works when you are mixing things like this. I remind you that the auxiliary verb, it's a connector. It's a fundamental base of creating sentences. Le verbe auxiliaire, ce sont des bases fondamentales pour créer une phrase, pour créer quelque chose qui va avoir un sens. Narudia hivi, tenzi unganishi, which is auxiliary verb, tenzi unganishi, ina umuhimu sana kwa sababu kazi yake ni kuunganisha tenzi na tenzi pamoja na maneno mengine ili kuleta maana ya msemo mzima unaouandika au unaouzungumza. For today, thank you so much. God bless you. After a short break, I will come with a reminder. You see down here, $25. $25, 50,000 shillings. I'll send you a short video which reminds about this, because after 30, you won't be able to get this again if you didn't pay your fee. Thank you so much. I like you all. God bless you. Have a great day.